Bobbering, Bobbering, where are you?
Oh my God, what happened?
The snails got me, but I managed to escape.
Where is it? Is it nearby?
There's one around in the corner of the island, and there's more of them.
There's more of them? How many?
There's like about a dozen.
Oh my God. I'm going to kill that snail that did this to you. But first, let me wrap up that arm.
Go. Oh, say it, it's you. Is it dead?
Yes, dead as doorknob. Three or four well-placed shots did the trick. I must say, Clavering, this is singular. I've dedicated years of my life and several fortunes to find these snails. They could have been phantoms for all I saw of them. And yet here you go on your first try, getting eaten by one. I must say, Clavering, you have very singular luck.
I wouldn't call this luck.
But think of all the possibilities now, Clavering. We'll come back, capture the babies, and put them on exhibition all over the world. This discovery will make us famous.
Put man-eating snails out on the loose, we must destroy these man-eating beasts once and for all.
This is what we have worked our whole lives for. Imagine all the possibilities. We could put the cetacean Clavering snails on display, the newfound species from the Kua Islands.
Consider this, every zoo will want one of these if we bring them back. If they escape into the wild, and rest assured they will breed rapidly and invade species. However many of them we try to kill, we will never succeed. European rabbits, cane toads, even bumsy pythons cannot be as destructive as these monstrous snails. If we kill the weak, they will come back larger and stronger and harder to kill than ever.
Clavering, dear fellow, can't you see that your imagination is getting the better of you? We'll keep the snails separated and under strict supervision. There are only 10 of them or so. We keep tigers and lions in zoos. Why not keep a couple of snails?
No, Clavering. These snails are more dangerous than you think.
Calm down. We'll do this our way. Why don't we go to sleep now? This has certainly been a long day.
Come in!
Hello, sir. You must be the Great Stead.
Take a seat. What do you come for?
It is an honor to see you in person. I've heard all about you in the news, capturing baby man-eating snails and all. Your discovery is truly remarkable. You already made billions off of selling them to zoos, experimenting.
Leave now.
I come to give you an offer.
What is this offer?
I come on behalf of a biomedical company, and we would like samples of these baby snails' blood.
What's this for?
We think that there just might be a special enzyme in these snails' blood that could possibly be a solution for curing cancer. We would like to give you $10,000 for one vial of snails' blood.
Sure, I'll tell my guards to give you access to my snails' den.
Thank you.
Come in.
Hello again.
Take a seat.
I'm back to say thank you for letting us buy your treasured snail's blood. We're making tremendous progress, and we think that there's a cure for cancer just around the corner.
You can leave now.
I see you like chess. I was a national winner at chess.
Really?
Come in. Come in.
You got a friend.
Come in.
You got a friend in me.
Come in.
When the road looks rough ahead.
Come in.
Your miles.
Come in.
And miles.
Come in.
Warm bed. You just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me.
Just tell me again for the 20th time.
How about we change things up? I'll take you on a game of basketball.
It's on.
If you got trouble, I got them too. That isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. If we stick together, we can see it through. Cause you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend.
All right. 1919 off. 1919. Whoever loses pays for dinner. Whoever loses pays for dinner. All right, Stan? What you got, Stan? What you got? Oh! Sold it! Sold it! Oh! Let's go! Let's go! What you got? Game four, man. All right, game four. What you got? Are you cut? Oh! Oh my goodness!
Oh. I just need to pay for dinner.
Sorry, man.
Oh. Sorry. Man, I want
this.
All right, good game, man. Good game. Hey, I know it's a really good restaurant. I'll take you there. Go right now.
Go.
Good game. Our
friendship will never die.
Mmm. Such a great restaurant.
I knew you would love it. So, Stead, tell me about your amazing adventure on the island of Kua, I believe.
Oh, it's been quite a ride, I have to say.
So, how did you end up on the island?
Well, as a zoologist, I thought I would do some research about the snails, because I heard that they had a lot of myths about these gigantic snails that lived there on the islands. So I thought I'd go there and check them out. And it turns out, just as my luck, I found them. And they were just sitting there, so I decided to take them back.
You went all alone?
I did.
Wow. Did you have any close encounters with the snails?
I have to say there was this one time, a snail approached me, but being a snail, it wasn't really that fast. So a few well-placed shots managed to take it down. That was the only close encounter I had.
It's remarkable how you went through all of this with no accompaniment.
Mm-hmm.
It's truly remarkable.
I truly felt terrified sometimes.
You must have. How did you escape the island?
My boat. That's how I got there. That's how I escaped.
So tell me more about these snails.
Well, they're quite slow, to be honest. One time, I had to take a poo so badly that when I took a poo and then they were 1 foot behind me, they were still there by the time, 20 minutes later after I left.
Wow, what a story.
Yeah, it's quite terrifying.
Yeah, you should tell that too.
I do.
A book on that.
I post it on my fan website and my Instagram.
What's your Instagram?
Snail Lover 226.
What an amazing name. I would love that name. Seriously?
Yeah.
Oh. Great. Okay. That's cool. Cool.
Please excuse me. I need to use the restroom.
Sure. We should start heading out soon.
Ah, we should. It's getting dark.
Yeah. I already paid, so it's all we can do for now. So.
Well, lose your place for dinner.
Yeah. Have some wine. I've asked the waiter, requested for a special wine from 22 BC.
Oh, why, thank you. How generous.
I know.
Mmm. Very strong.
Like it?
I liked it.
Yeah. Alright, let's start heading out. It's getting dark.
It is. Let's go.
It was a great dinner.
It was.
I suddenly feel so
tired.
Yeah, you must be. We had a long day today. Go ahead and go sleep. Stead, I know what you have done. At the den, I got my vial of blood, and I was heading out when something caught my eye. A human bone. I became curious, so I called a gene agency to match the DNA of the bone to its owner. I became friends with you to obtain more information about who you are and what you did on that island. But over that time, I slowly took down my walls, and I began to see you as a person, as a friend. I enjoy spending long and lazy summer days with you, playing chess, drinking iced lemonade, and talking about the latest developments in biotechnology. Weeks later, I received a letter in the mail. It was from the gene agency, and the DNA results had come in. The bone belonged to a man named Clavering. I had no idea what that meant, but with only a night's research, I figured it out. I figured out that you are a murderer. This is unforgivable, but I felt that in our short sliver of time together, we had really connected and had become good friends. I couldn't find the courage to report you to my boss. So now we are here. Here I give you a chance. One last chance.
Where am I?
Babe!
What the?